To get a perspective on this special report, I have the pleasure today to have on my show one of the most renowned health experts, Dr. Shikha Sharma. She's now also a founder of NutriWell India Health Private Limited. Thank you so much, Dr. Sharma, for joining me today. The report that we saw where people are suddenly feeling that they have increased anxiety, but physically that there is a weight gain that they never felt they could gain weight so easily and so quickly ever before the pandemic started. What advice do you suggest to people watching this show right now who are facing sudden health concerns?
See, fundamentally, I would say that there are three things which are very important. The first thing is that we have to start including those foods in our eating plan which are immune boosters. Now, fundamentally, the kind of immune boosters which exist are, for example, having more of amla or Indian gooseberry, having a lot of vegetable juices which have things like pumpkin, tomatoes, then ginger, carrot, apple, so vegetable juice, beetroot. So tomato, beetroot, pumpkin, these kind of vegetable juices also boost immunity through the gut. So they make the intestine healthy and boost immunity. For people who might have digestive issues, and normally yes. We suggest that you should have more of triphala, which is according to the Indian Vedic system, it is something which balances the gut bacteria. It's not a laxative, it is a gut balancer or a rasayan. So that is one. So and of course, fruits and salads have to be included. For people who are diabetic, grains like quinoa is better than rice or wheat or bread. Bread definitely should be avoided. It's a massive cause for blood sugar fluctuation. So more like quinoa or brown rice or whole grains, millets, all those are much better grains. Then one thing which is also very important is that we have to use more spices which are therapeutic spices. So like, of course, as Indians, we love spices, but therapeutic spices are like turmeric. And if you drink milk, have turmeric milk rather than plain milk. Similarly, have ginger in your routine, which is like you can have a 1 teaspoon of ginger juice in your daily routine. Similarly, if you have black pepper, it makes our upper respiratory tract free of congestion. So those are very important things. The next thing I would say is that because of lockdown, people are not able to move out in the last few months. But even people today, because of it could be the weather or it could be traffic, they don't have access to gardens and other places. So start yoga at home. And in yoga, Surya Namaskar is one of the most comprehensive exercises which I can think of. It's just a set of 12 postures and you do it every day, number of rounds, the number of repetitions depending on your. So that is wonderful. And third, I would say stress management. A lot of people have been really badly stressed out. And I think for stress management, different people should use different techniques. Like some people use music as a stress management technique. Some people do chanting. Some people do breath exercises like pranayama or breath exercises. Some people do dancing. So I think stress management has to be taken as a structured initiative at home also, rather than just doing it when you're stressed, because the stressors are going to continue. So that is why it's important to include some of these stress management techniques in your daily life. I personally use chanting and pranayama as a way to manage my stress. And I think it really works because you don't need too much of space and you can do it anywhere. Even before sleeping, you can do a little bit of breath exercises and that helps.
So that would be holistic wellness and good diet as well. But what kind of medical tests would you suggest to someone who is facing perhaps health concerns right now? Once they have consulted an expert, what kind of tests should we get done to be sure about the problems that we may be facing?
So I think if you look at your stress management, there are various assessments which can be done with any good counselor. They will assess you. They will see your coping mechanism. They will, like, you know, simple things like how much are you sleeping? Are you getting good sleep? Are you feeling like dressing up? Are you feeling like good? So a lot of these assessment things done with a professional help them to gauge whether they are stressed out or not, or what is the level of stress they are going through. The second thing, of course, is a blood test. I think I would suggest everybody who is, of a certain age, more than say 35, should get a basic wellness profile done, so that at least you know how's your liver, how's your blood sugar, how's your cholesterol.